Hi students, now in this session we will understand about inheritance of traits. Traits means nothing but characters which are mainly transferred from our parents to in our body, means parents to offsprings, or you may call newborn babies. Especially the word, see, okay, inheritance means, how to define this one? To understand this one, we will once we go through about Mendel's contributions, then we will understand this concept very clearly. This concept is mainly applicable to genetics. Have you heard about genetics? Genetics is a branch of biological sciences which deals with the transmission of characteristics from one generation to the next, and also the action of hereditary units called genes. They bring about the characteristics which they control. So guys, here you understand about one of the important person, Gregor Johann Mendel, appropriately known as father of genetics, proposed the theory of inheritance. He performed his experiments on garden pea and formulated the laws of which explain the manner of inheritance of characters. From 1856 to 1865, Mendel conducted breeding experiments on garden peas, scientifically called as Physum sativum, in the garden of his monastery, and was luckily the first to formulate clear-cut principles or laws of heredity. So we will understand some more points about Gregor Johann Mendel. Through his work on pea plants, discovered the fundamental laws of inheritance. He deduced that genes come in pairs and are inherited as distinct units. See the word. Genes are the distinct units, one from each parent. Mendel tracked the segregation of parental genes and their appearance in the offspring as dominant or recessive traits. Mendelian inheritance is a type of biological inheritance that follows the principles originally proposed by Gregor Mendel in 1865. And 1866, rediscovered in 1900 and popularized by William Bateson, when Mendel's theories were integrated with the Boveri-Sutton chromosome theory of inheritance. You heard about these two names, no? Okay, Boveri-Sutton, who gave chromosomal theory of inheritance. Now, here we understand one more name, this is Thomas Hunt Morgan, you may call T.H. Morgan, in 1915. They became the core of classical genetics. So, whatever these scientists gave the information is nothing but a core of classical genetics. Ronald Fisher combined these ideas with the theory of natural selection in his 1930 book, The Genetical Theory of Natural Selection, footing evolution onto a mathematical footing and forming the basis for population genetics with the modern evolutionary synthesis. Here we will understand about Mendel's Genetic discoveries. Five parts of Mendel's discoveries were an important divergence from the common theories that the time and were the prerequisite for the establishment of his rules. Characters are unitary, that is, they are a discrete. Example: purple versus white, tall versus dwarf. There is no medium-sized plant or light purple flower. This one you understand first. It may be purple or white. It may be tall or dwarf. There is no medium-sized plant. Genetic characteristics have alternate forms, each inherited from one of two parents. Today we call these alleles. One allele is dominant over the other. The phenotype reflects the dominant allele. Gametes are created by random segregation. Heterozygotic individuals produce gametes with an equal frequency of the two alleles. We will understand this one by using alphabetical notations. Different traits have independent assortment. In modern terms, genes are unlinked, or you may call unlinked. Mendel selected for the experiment the following characters of pea plants. Form of the ripe seeds, color of the seed coat, color of the seeds and cotyledons, flower color, form of the ripe pods, color of the unripe pods, position of the flowers and length of the stem. You may better understand by using this picture. Means Mendel identified 7 pea plant characteristics, or you may call 7 pair of contrasting traits, like seeds. You may see the form like round and wrinkled, then about the cotyledon, yellow green. So when you come to flower, it may be white or violet. When you come to pod, form is full and constricted, color is green and yellow. So when you come to stem size, it may be tall and short. When you come to flower position, it may be axial as well as terminal. Likewise, you see in some different traits or 7 pea plant characteristics are listed by Mendel. Here we chose some important traits and some extra also given, like pod, axial pods, terminal pods. In some cases we can say about the flower position also, axial flower, terminal flower. When you come across with Mendel's work, what you seen, what you understand? Mendel developed a new method to control exactly how the pea plants were fertilized. By using self-fertilization, means we are getting a pure breed. Always produces offspring with the same trait as the parent plant. He also made them cross-pollination or cross-fertilization. Produces offspring that may be different or the same as the parent plant. So when you come to different, it indicates what? Hybrids. Means, hybrid means is a combination of two different varieties. Mendel crossed these pure breeding lines of plants and recorded the traits of the hybrid progeny. He found that all of the first F1 means first generation hybrids look like first of the parent plants. For example, all the progeny of a purple and white flower cross were purple. However, when he allowed the hybrid plants to self-pollinate, the hidden traits would appear in the second generation hybrid plants. So that one we will see in the next slide by using schematic representations. So you may understand here again two points like dominant and recessive traits. Mendel described each of the trait variants as dominant or recessive. Dominant traits like purple flower color appeared in the F1 hybrids. Whereas recessive traits like white flower color did not. You understood like this, okay, please. Which is dominant, which is recessive. Which is appear in the F1 generation is dominant, which is not expressly is called as a recessive. Mendel did thousands of crossbreeding experiments. His key finding was that there were three times as many dominant as recessive traits in F2 pea plants. So you may understand here by using this cross, or it is called as a mono hybrid cross between a tall and a dwarf plants. So when Mendel crossed, means especially pea plants are self-pollinate plants, self-pollinate flowers. But Mendel, he is doing here cross-pollination, or you may call hybridization experiments, you may call better. It is called as artificial hybridization experiments. Means he is going to manually cross tall and dwarf plants. Then what is the F1 generation? You got all tall plants with heterozygous genotypes. Then when F1 generation plants are selfed, remember here comes self-pollination. What happens in F2 generation? When F1 generation plants are selfed, then what you got? F2 generation shows three tall plants and only one dwarf plant. This indicates what? The trait which is not expressed in the F1 generation is now expressed in F2 generation. This means F1 plants were found to have only one type of trait. Only one type of trait. That is a tall. F2 generation had two types of plants. A large number of the traits found in F1 generation and a smaller number of the traits, other trait is not appeared in F1 generation. In all cases, the ratio was 3:1. Mendel's results can be explained using a specific example. Means here we already given that schematic representation. When tall plants were crossed with the dwarf plants, all plants in the F1 generation were tall. The plants used in the initial cross are referred to as P1 and P2 or parents. When the F1 plants were self-fertilized, both the tall and dwarf plants were obtained in the F2 generation. The tall and dwarf plants were obtained in a ratio close to 3:1. 3:1 is the ratio in the F2 generation. Similar patterns were obtained for other six pairs of characters also. Remember, here we used only one trait, that is the height of the plant. For any character, the F1 individuals derived from crosses between two different varieties having alternative characters showed only one of the traits and never the other. This picture was expressed as a dominance of one trait over the other. The trait which appeared in the F1 generation was called dominant, and other which did not appear in the F1 population was called recessive. In upcoming slide, we will understand about laws which are given by Mendel after these crosses. Thank you.